Frank Leonard Skinner. Ronnie always talked about the guys in Muscle Shoals. Apparently, they had gone up there and recorded an entire album with Jimmy Johnson producing.
I guess I showed up to rehearsal a little bit after everybody else, because when I got there, Gary was playing a riff sort of like this. It went to... and pick up my strat and just bounce that mine off of his. And Ronnie's sitting over in his, on the couch where he always sat, and he kept going like this. That means don't stop. Just keep running it, running it down. So within about 15 minutes, he started writing the chorus. So he had a verse on the chorus. And he says, well, I'll see you later. I'm going down to go fishing. Okay. So we stayed up there and we're working on the music. He's listening down there. He's the music traveled down the creek really well. And he comes back, I guess, in about an hour and a half and grabs the mic and he sings all the verses. He always wrote in his head. He never wrote anything down. So we were able to kind of arrange it.
Ronnie had always talked about the guys in Muscle Shoals. Then when we wrote Sweet Home Alabama, the last verse says, Muscle Shoals has got the Swampers. And when Ronnie, what is that, Swampers? He goes, oh, that's Jimmy and Roger and the guys in Muscle Shoals. Given that name by Denny Cordell, who was the producer with Leon Russell. I think he just thought it sounded good, you know, because the Muscle Shoals is a lot of water here. You gotta have a name, and Swampers is a good nickname.
There's two guitar solos in that song, one short one, one very long one, and they both came to me in a dream. Absolutely note for note, all the transition points, the fingering, the chord voicings. I woke up out of the dream, picked up the guitar, and it was done.
Yeah, I remember very clearly. And after it was done that day, Ronnie looked at me and he goes, well, he goes, there's our Ramblin' Man. You know, the Allman Brothers had Ramblin' Man. It's their big hit, and that was our Ramblin' Man. We just knew it was a hit record, you know. It was funny, MCA didn't release that first. They didn't, I guess, hear it as a hit. They released, I guess, Don't Ask Me No Questions off the Second Helping album first. And, of course, Alabama was a clear-cut hit off that record.